Got me thinking about an earthquake. You in here making a herbquake.
Now, Herbert and Henry.
Damn!
I just want to put my belly on your back.
Have some huge problems.
We better win this 1500 today, or else we gonna be out on the street.
Welcome to the Yachts and Yachties Rap Battle!
Vanilla Ice, I'm gonna use you as my bitch. I'm gonna get you some lip gloss.
And even when they...
Hey, it's your girl, Adrian Monroe, and you are watching The Adrian Monroe Show with a very special guest, Mr. Jamal Mixon.
What up, Adrian? What's the deal, man?
A.K.A. Hercules. Hey!
Still get it to this day. It's all good. I don't care.
Keep it going. How you doing?
I'm doing good, man. How you doing, man?
I've been good. I've been grinding out here.
Nothing wrong with that.
Trying to make it happen. What's been going on lately? Like, what you been working on?
Man, you know, right now, we just been still out here grinding in this entertainment industry. Man, you know how it go. It can be up and downs, you know. But right now, we working on this little Netflix deal. Me and my brother, we've been trying to holler at Flavor Unit and stuff and get the rights to do the cookout again. But it said me and my brother, we throw the cookout this time, Willie and Nelson's cookout. So, you know, I've been working on that script. And I've been working on It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Y'all make sure y'all check it out. It's out there right now, FX, Netflix, Redbox, everything. You know, still at it.
Still
don't stop
at it. So I want to know, like, how did you get started? Like, how did you get that role in The Nutty Professor?
Well, you know, we go way back in. Right. So, you know, you already know my mom's. You know how crazy my mom's
was. Yeah.
You already know.
Shout out to Gay Nam.
Yeah, you already know. So, you know, my mom's came to me and was like, you know, I heard they doing this audition for this movie with Eddie Murphy, and they looking for a chubby kid. And she was like, well, you chubby, so what you know, let's go out there on Saturday and let's see if we can get it. And I went to the audition, and it was a bunch of kids, you know how that go when it's open call. I went to the audition, and the director was like, eat a cookie and laugh. Here's a cookie, here's a Coca-Cola, eat this and laugh. So I'm like, well, shit, this ain't no audition, I do this every day. Give me that cookie and that Coke. So I ate the cookie, drunk the Coke, started laughing, and Tom Shadyac, he just fell in love with me and was like, you know, I think you'll be perfect for the part. So I want you to come to Universal Studios, and I want you to meet with the star of the movie. Mm. Now, at the time, I didn't know the star was Eddie Murphy. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, even though I was young, you know, growing up in the 80s, you still watch Eddie Murphy, Raw and Delirious. You know who Eddie Murphy is, Coming to America and all that. So I go to Universal Studios, and boom, Eddie Murphy right there, just like, let's do it. He talking to me. I'm like, man, this is... Can I cuss on this show? I don't know if you cuss or not. I'm like, man, this is fucking Eddie Murphy right here. I'm
right. Next to.
So we did our little thing, and we know what the director was like. The chemistry was perfect, and there you go. It's been on and cracking ever since then.
Wow. And then I checked you out over there using Gridlock Iron.
Gridiron Gang.
Gridiron Gang.
It's all good. It's all good. Shoot, man, I did, you know, Gridiron Gang, man, The Cookout, How to Be a Player, Nutty Professor 1 and 2. Shit, the Parkers. I played Kim Boyfriend on there for a minute. Shoot, man, the list goes on, man. Yeah. I did a lot of stuff, man.
This is serious right here. This is big. Like, you are big in this industry. And yes. I know that you are looking to expand.
Yeah.
You know, your acting roles.
You know, everybody be like, hey, man, what's up, man? What y'all been doing? Or, you know, like, whoop de whoop. You know, I'm like, man, we just been chilling. I mean, you know, we did a lot of, you know, our credits go a long way.
Right.
You know, we done work with Eddie Murphy. My brother done work with Jim Carrey, Vince Vaughn, shit, Will Ferrell, all these people, you know. And it's like, we get offers still to this day, but it's always the same thing, man. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like, they just want us to be these dudes that's going to sit on the set and eat all day and smoke weed all day. Right. Like, nah, I'm trying to branch off, bro, onto some whole different shit. So, mm-hmm. you know, that's why, like, everything we've been doing, if you notice, you know, we did our movie White Tee, me and my brother, you know, and we basically produced that and did that ourselves. And, you know, we just been trying to take that next step where, like, you know, we could co-star with people and, you know, do that. But, man, we looking for our own thing right now. You know, that's our main focus.
Yeah.
So that's why we working on this little Netflix deal right now, trying to get with them and, you know, get the rights to this cookout so we can redo it again and make it great.
Yeah. So... You looking to do the rights, and we need some people to cooperate so that we can bring this. Right now, we need it. We need a good, funny film
Flavor
right
Unit,
now.
holla at your boy. You already know we've been making the calls. We're trying to get that Willie and Nelson cookout popping. It's gonna be funny.
Well, can I be in it?
Come on, man.
You mean at this
know,
time?
You already know we go way back, man. You already
let
know
me get
you
a
up
role
in there.
And
you already know. Guaranteed.
All right, y'all. So you watching the Adrian Monroe Show with Mr. Jamal Mixon, and we'll be right back.
Yeah.
Your family got any money? I ain't paying for no big ass wedding.
Oh, Carla, I know a wonderful minister. What religious background are you?
Yeah, you know, I still got my wedding dress if you want it. I'll take it in and let you wear. You look so lovely, Aaron. It's white, though. Can you wear a white wedding dress, young lady? Now, Sherman, you can wear a white tuxedo. Did you know Sherman?
Mom, no, you're going to embarrass my baby.
Don't pick out a strong back. When you get all that man and release all that that's been built up for 35 years, just wanting and wanting and wanting, whoo, might make your head blow off.
Pop, go to Weezer.
I got my own self hot telling that story.
Pop, go to Weezer, because Weezer say pop. Yeah, Carla, you and Sherman going
to
get me.
Welcome back to the Adrian Monroe Show with your boy, Mr. Javoy Mixon.
Yeah.
Once again, I want to know, what do you do outside of working and acting and doing your music, too? You did some music,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, you know, we still in the studio, too. Yeah. That's coming on the way, too. You already know.
Right.
What I do, I play video games. Anybody out there want to challenge me on 2K19, holla at your boy right now.
Okay, well, what's your name on there?
You already know. You know it's Hercules.
Okay, I know, but they don't know.
Big Hercules, PlayStation Network. Send an invite. We can get down all day. But for the most part, I just be chilling, man. You know, just enjoying life, man.
Right.
You know, going out, partying. You know, the typical LA lifestyle, man. Nothing, you know, might hit a little something every now and then. You know, drink a little something here and there, but not too much. Nothing. That's why you ain't never heard about me and my brother in jail or some crazy shit, because we don't get down like that.
Yeah.
You know, my mom taught us better than that.
Right, so. And that's important to have a good family support system,
yeah,
and foundation,
man,
at the end of the day.
Exactly.
You know, rest in peace,
exactly,
to Gaynell. She,
yes,
was an amazing woman.
Yes, she was.
And so now you have your father, who,
yeah,
is
OG.
I love him. He's
Danny,
amazing,
you
too.
You already know.
Yeah. And he gives you your support system, and he have y'all back, like, to the fullest.
My pops always, everybody who is in the industry, they know my pops. They, mm-hmm, know the curl. Still rocking the curl to this day. It ain't going to change. 30 years later, he still got the curl cracking, swinging all over the place. And, you know, my pops, man, my pops low-key.
Yeah.
He keep us straight, make sure we not out there doing no foolishness or nothing like that, but
mm-hmm.
I mean, man, you know
yeah, yeah. So what's up with the ladies? Like, I mean, you got a lady that keep you in place too? Like, what's going,
yeah,
on?
Yeah, you come on now. Your lady gonna turn down all this right here. You know what I'm saying?
It's getting cold right now. We,
yeah, yeah, exactly.
To keep us warm.
I'm keeping them warm all winter. Don't even worry about that. I got heaters too. If that don't work, we straight. We'll be good.
Right.
But yeah, I got a girl. You know how relationships go. You have your ups and downs and,
yeah,
all that. But we good right now.
That's good.
We're in a good place.
That's a blessing. I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah.
And I'm happy when you happy.
Yeah,
you know, I got mad love for you.
You already know, man.
Yeah.
Come on now. I'm always, like, I don't want to say I'm always cheerful or happy even if something happens, but, you know, I think Little Duval said it best, living your best life.
Right.
I ain't going back with you niggas.
Right, right.
I'm living my best life, man. So, you know, you can sit up and have frowny faces all day,
mm-hmm,
or be mad or be angry, but where does that get you?
Right.
It gets you nowhere, you know. So that's why I just be like, if something don't go the way I want it, I'm just like, all right, pushing on to the next one.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Don't make no sense to stress over it, because stress is just going to mess you up even more.
Right.
So I'm just pushing under the rug and on to the next one.
Staying positive.
You know, it's been parts that we wanted to get that we didn't get and all that. Like the Fat Albert, when that came, when we was auditioning for that, you know, we got close to getting it when Forrest Whitaker was the director, but they changed the director and did all that. So, you know, we didn't get it, but
yeah,
ain't no tripping.
Right, right.
On to the next one.
Right. Well, I hope that everything works out with the cookout and,
yeah,
you get in the roles that you really want, that you can elevate to the,
yeah,
next level.
Yeah,
you
most
know,
definitely.
And be behind the scenes,
see,
creating and making things happen.
That's
too.
That's why I did It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia when I got the offer, because I don't know if y'all watched the show, but it's Dennis, and, you know, I played Black Dennis.
Okay.
So I basically was, it was completely something completely different than I ever did because I had to mimic him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I had to follow every step that he did. So I had to sit there and study this dude. So when we filmed it, you know, it was in a reflection, they were black people. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Mm. When people see them, they were black.
Right.
So it's a whole episode. The gang turns black. Check it out. It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. It's hilarious. The ending is kind of, you know, they were trying to get a point across.
Okay.
And that's why I did it. Because, mm-hmm. you know, if you watch it and you see the ending, you'd be like, yeah, that would happen if you were black.
Okay. So y'all go check that out. Always Sunny in Philadelphia featuring this talented, multi-talented man, Jerway Mixon. And I appreciate
Jamal
everybody. Jamal. Sorry, so I get them confused.
Adrian, don't.
All right, Jerroy, next time, you better be here. Exactly. We need you here next time, all right? We love you, too. Thank you for being family.
You probably better call me Taco, you know.
All right, Taco. So I call him Taco. So right now, I'm keeping it professional right now. You Jamal Mixon. And this is the Adrian Monroe Show. Thank you for tuning in.
Yeah.
And don't forget to check us out soon.
Check us out.
Peace out.